Let's assume in our slightly more realistic world, where households now start saving a part of their income. This would mean that only a part of the income that they receive goes into consumer expenditure. This also means that now firms receive less of this monetary flow from consumer expenditure and they shell out more in the form of income. Therefore, firms fall short of money since consumer expenditure minus income is now negative. In order to buy plant and equipment and additional inventories, firms now need to borrow money. This investment can be divided into capital investment or inventory investment. And we have seen the definitions of capital investment and inventory investment before. In the real world, the savings by households goes into the financial markets, either into stocks, bonds, deposits, and banks, etc. Firms, on the other hand, need to fund their cash shortfall and hence borrow from the financial markets. This market where firms borrow and where the households' savings flow is called the capital markets. It is the capital markets that link savings and investments. So in the slightly more realistic scenario with the addition of savings and investments, we see that firms need to borrow for investments to fund the cash shortfall and receive consumer expenditure from households. Firms pay out incomes, so now households receive incomes and pay out consumer expenditure plus savings.